The question asked is the significance of silence in spiritual life. What is the importance of silence in spiritual life? How it is to be practiced? A beautiful story comes to my mind. I have heard the story of Veera Brahmendra of Andhra Pradesh, the saint called Veera Brahmendra. Veera Brahmendra, as a young boy, was a brilliant student. He studied under a guru in Kumbakonam. As a young boy, he picked up many things. He learned Upanishads, Vedanta, Veda, everything very quickly. He was very, very intelligent, very smart. He was the most brilliant boy in the class. Guru was very happy with him. In those days, after Gurukula education, the children used to be sent to internship, study or work under the guidance of some king or any other work. So just like what we do internship nowadays, they used to send for internship. The guru sent him to the palace of Mysore Maharaja for internship, for study. Veera Brahmendra goes to the palace and the king gives him a job. King gives him an assignment. Assignment of evaluating the scholars who are coming to king for remuneration. So there are so many scholars, so many poets in the kingdom of Mysore. They used to come and show their talent in the king's palace. They will come and praise king and show their talent. The king will give remuneration or prize or gift. The king gave the job of evaluating the scholars to Veera Brahmendra. Brahmendra, being very intelligent, he used to ask questions, cross questions to the scholars to show their faults. He used to give low marks to all the people because they cannot answer, because this guy is so brilliant. And they, many of the scholars who used to get good prizes from the king, they are not getting any prizes at all. They are getting depressed. And imagine those days, right? If you want to get some money or prize, you have to go to king only. There is no other avenue. So Veera Brahmendra became a block for the scholars to get some prize from the king. Every scholar, he will make them feel as if they don't know anything, because he will show his talent, Veera Brahmendra, and make people feel they don't know anything. The scholars got very worried. They went and complained to the guru of Veera Brahmendra. Your student is preventing the scholars getting from prizes. Please help. Many of the scholars are poor. When they go to king's court in the hope of getting some prize, Veera Brahmendra is putting them down with his scholarship and intelligence. Veera Brahmendra is very intelligent. Guru calls Veera Brahmendra and tells him, What are you doing? You are talking too much. In the process, you are depriving the scholars of their gift, the prize. Don't talk too much. This is the instruction which was given by the Guru. Veera Brahmendra immediately takes the instruction from the Guru. The Guru's words is a command, is a blessing. Veera Brahmendra thought, the Guru has given him a blessing to stop talking. And he just stopped talking from that day onwards. But Veerabhin Brahmendra, being a very, very intelligent boy, realized that stopping talking verbally is not really a solution in life. In that stopping talking, through mouth you cannot may not talk, through the body you may not be able to talk, but the mind was very noisy for him. The mind keeps on talking internally, the mental noise. So Veera Brahmendra inquired, who is talking? He found the nature of the self, Atma, as the silence. Once he found the nature of self, silence, Atma, he became totally silent. Now, verbally or through the body, he doesn't speak. The mind is silent. And he was immersed in Brahman or Supreme Consciousness. There was a radiance from his face. There's a deep silence which was emanating from him. People used to come and do namaskara to him. He has attained Brahman, whose nature is silence. Your nature of self is silence. Body and mind are just instruments for speaking, but who speaks is the self. So he has found the source or the speaker, the in essence, the Atma, which whose nature is silence. Many people came and told his guru that Veera Brahmendra has become very silent. He is not speaking, and many people are feeling his presence soothing. They are going to do namaskara. You told him not to speak. He has stopped speaking. Can you ask him to speak? That's what people told to Guru. Guru said, people said, looks like he has become mad because of your instruction. Guru said, I wish I can also have that madness. My student is blessed. I also want to have that madness where I am established in silence. The silence of the self, the silence of Atman, silence of Brahman. So that is the silence. So now, many times, instruction is given to people on the spiritual path observe silence. So, if you don't understand the teaching of spirituality, you can completely mess up your life. What is the meaning of observe the silence? Why it is valuable in spiritual life? This you have to understand. The silence of the speech, the silence of the body, silence of the mind, silence of the self. What silence you have to observe? Let us look at the speech. We speak. When we speak, our energy gets drained. Any activity, including speech, drains our energy. If I do physical activity, our energy gets drained. We do mental activity, energy gets drained. If I do verbal activity, our energy gets drained, because every activity requires energy, shakti, prana. So this pranic energy, which is required for walking, talking, speech, has to be conserved by a spiritual practitioner. How do you conserve your energy in spiritual practice? Find out which things are not useful for your spiritual sadhana and reduce it. There are many things in our life we are doing wasteful activity. Our focus should be on the karma yoga, the service, yajna. Karma yoga is offering to God. Yajna is offering to the society. In that form, offering to God. And shravana, manana, nidhyasa. It is called tapas. Karma yoga, yajna, tapas is what we have to spend. We do lot of wasteful activity. We keep on talking nonsense. A spiritual seeker has to observe silence. Means he has to observe his speech. We are doing lot of wasteful speech. The speech about the past, the speech about the future. When somebody talks, observe. They keep on going to the past. They keep on going to the future. Oh, what happened 10 years back? What happened 20 years back? Worry, anxiety, they keep on expressing through speech. We have to learn to live in the present moment, not in the past, not in the future, because the nature of self is the present moment. What you can talk about present moment? There is little you can talk about present moment. What is required for your transaction? What is required for your living? That you can talk. So reduce the speech by observe your speech. First, when you say observe silence, means observe your speech. Reduce unwanted speech. What is unwanted? Unwanted is the thoughts of the past, thoughts of the future. What is wanted is what is required for the present moment, the now. So that is speech. So observe silence means observe your speech. See what unwanted speech you are doing. What is unwanted, always understand, is always related to the past and future. What is wanted is what is required for the present moment, for your transaction. Suppose you have to work in your office. So office related work you have to talk. If you don't talk, the work cannot be done. Because speech gets converted into work. The present moment, what is required for your survival, what is required for your transaction, you have to speak. You have to use very less number of words to get the work done. So observe silence means observe your speech and reduce unwanted speech of the past or future. What is required for the present moment? Do it well, speak well, and get the work done. So there is a saying in Sanskrit, Satyam Bruyat, Priyam Bruyat, Na Bruyat, Satyam Priyam, Priyam Cha Nanratam Bruyat, Esha Dharma Sanadhaha. So, observe silence means observe the discipline of speech. Discipline of speech is called Vak Tapasya. Vak Tapasya is Satyam Bruyat. Whenever we speak, as much as possible, we should be truthful. Being truthful is Vak Tapasya. Continuously thinking of the past or continuously thinking of future is being untruthful, because past and future don't exist, only present moment exists. Vak Tapasya is Satyam Bruyat. Be in the present moment, speak the truth. Priyam Bruyat, you have to talk. Priyam means what is good for the people, good for the society, good for progress of anybody. In the sense, our speech can make others depressed. Our speech can motivate people. Our speech can inspire people. Speak. What is priyam? Means speak what inspires people, what energizes people. Don't speak what causes hurt or depression in people. So speaking the right thing, the inspiring thoughts, is Vak Tapasya. Speak the words which encourage, which bring the best in people, which bring the divinity in the people. What can bring divinity in the people? The teaching of the realized masters, Sadgurus, the teaching of Rishis, the Upanishad, Vedanta, Bhagavad Gita. This brings the best in people. It brings the divinity in the people. Speak the divine truths as much as possible. Speak to motivate people. Speak to inspire people. This is called Priyam Bruyat. We have to speak the truth, Satyam Bruyat. We have to speak Priyam Bruyat. We should talk. We should cut down what is unnecessary, what doesn't fall into this category. What is Satyam? Satyam is the truth, the knowledge of self, Atmadana, the teaching of Sadguru, teaching of Rishi is Satyam. You speak. In that process, you get purified and the listeners get purified. That's Satya. Priyam Bruyat. This will only help people. Priyam. Right? Priyam doesn't mean praising some people. Praising, like we do a lot of ego boosting activity. Oh, you are good, yeah. So they appear to be priya, but they don't help person. Priyam is something which brings the best in somebody, that motivates the person, inspires the person. Inspires the person to achieve something in life, that's okay. Or inspire the person to find the divinity in himself. Atmadnana, this is called priyam. Priyam cha nanratam bruyat. You may be telling the priya, what is good for the person, but nanratam, don't tell false. So you may say, you may want to motivate some person. Okay? You may say something, but don't tell lies to motivate some person. Priyam cha nandratam bruyat. Esha dharma sanatanaha. This is the ancient wisdom. This is the vak tapasya or tapasya or spiritual practice of speech. A spiritual seeker has to practice Vak Tapasya. What it means is, be moderate in speech. Don't get into past or future. What is required for the present moment, for your karma yoga, for your activity, for yajna, and yajna, you do that. What is required to motivate people, inspire people, bring out the best in them, either for action, either for activity or success in life, or spiritual enlightenment. in terms of Rishi Vakya, you do that. This silence doesn't mean keeping your mouth shut. If you keep your mouth shut, what is the difference between you and an animal? Animals also can't speak. So speech, vaktapasya, is not keeping your mouth shut, but having the right kind of speech. So now, being silent also helps in spiritual practice. In the sense, if you are silent, then you are able to observe the mind. If you keep on doing some activity, you are not able to observe the mind. Keeping your mouth shut helps you to observe the mind. That's why when you sit for meditation, you should not chant mantra or do japa, because your mouth, your body gets active, and in that process you are not able to observe the mind. So be silent means reduce your activity when you are sitting for meditation, so that you are able to observe your mind. I told you three parts of activity in our daily life. What is karma yoga? Whatever action we have to do in life, we have to do it as karma yoga, as a service. That time you have to speak. But speak what is required rather than getting into all nonsense. Getting the work, doing the work efficiently, you speak. Then there is yadna. Second part of the activity in life is called yadna. Service. For doing service, you have to speak. But speak what is required. When you do dnana yadna, speak the words of the truth. That's yadna. And then third part of our life is our own spiritual sadhana or tapasya, which involves shravana, manana, nididhyasa. So shravana, you listen to some guru. When you are listening to some guru, silently listen. Manana, you contemplate. And nididhyasa, you become silent. In that silence also, there is no forceful silence. In nididhyasa, you remember the words of spiritual teaching, the nature of atma. Who am I? Aham brahmasmi. Sarvam khaluda brahma. These are the spiritual teachings you have to remember. And go to the source of speech. So for that, you have to be able to observe the mind. And when you observe the mind, you see there are gaps in the mind. There are gaps in our thoughts. And in that gaps in the thoughts, the self is revealed. If you are continuous, the mind is active. There are no gaps in the thought. You cannot observe the gaps in the thought. Observe the gaps in the thought. In the process of observing the gap in the thought, you recognize the observer, the Atma, the Self. So observe the silence means really observe the observer. Who is the observer? Is the Atma. To observe the observer, we have to recognize gaps in our thoughts. We have to recognize gaps, silence in our activity. We have to recognize the silence in the external world. So, actually, vaktapasya means not forcefully stopping the speech. Vaktapasya means being able to observe the gaps in our thought. Being able to observe the silence in our speech. When you have that silence, you recognize the observer or the sakshi or the atma. In reality, observe the speech, observe the silence doesn't mean about the body and mind. It is the silence of the self. So be silent means you are nature is silence. You are the Atma. Atma is silent witness. Atma is the silent witness of all the activity. Have you observed the Atma? Observe that Atma which is silent, which is present as a silent witness in all the activities of life. That is the real meaning of observe the silence. And this silence is very dynamic. It is not dead silence of a smashana. It is not silence of dead wood. It is not the silence of the animals. It's a dynamic silence. In every speech, there is silence. In every sound, there is silence. The silence and sound, they go together. The activity and inactivity go together. So if you are able to observe the activity and inactivity, we are observing the totality. And the one who is observing the totality is yourself, Atma, the Sakshi. You are able to take your attention back to the self. The nature of self is recognized in silence. A jnani, when he speaks also, he is speaking in silence. The words flow out of silence. Whereas a ajnani, even if he is silent, is not silent because his mind is active. There is noise in the mind. Just because somebody doesn't speak, don't think he is silent. The mental noise is there. The suppression of mental noise is not solution. Stopping of the speech is not solution. Being aware of the self, who am I? Inquire into the nature of self. That is silence. When you inquire into the nature of self, you recognize that even if you are in the middle of lot of activities, you are silent. There's a beautiful dynamic silence in you. That is the Atma, that is the Sakshi. Observe the silence means observe the observer, the Sakshi, who is real nature. And one who has found that real nature, even is speaking, there is silence. Because his speech brings the silence in the listener. It's very easy to wrongly understand any spiritual teaching. Okay, the spiritual teaching is always pointing you to take your attention to the self. Take your attention to Atma. But we convert the spiritual teaching into an activity. For example, there's a teaching that without becoming sannyasi, nobody can be liberated. Now, people start thinking that, oh, sannyasi means leaving the house, leaving the family and going to some forest. That's not the meaning of that. The nature of the self is sannyasa. The Atma is sannyasa. Atma is completely unattached. So, taking sannyasa is a physical activity. But recognizing who is sannyasi, the self, is real sannyasa. The nature of the self is sannyasa. So the instruction, spiritual eating instruction, is always take your attention to the source, which is self. But we convert that into activity. Sannyasa becomes an activity. That's not the solution. So then there is another teaching. Become a non-doer. So you stop doing everything. That's not non-doership. The self is non-doer. The self is the witness of all activity. It is a non-doer. To recognize the self, that is sannyasa, that is non-doership. So entire spiritual activity has been misunderstood. The spiritual instruction is always about taking your attention to the self or the source. That has been converted into a physical activity or verbal activity or mental activity. That is not right understanding. The self-inquiry, who am I, is the real spiritual silence. Then even if you speak, there is silence in you. Your speech doesn't affect inner silence. Atma's nature is silence. Find out who you are. That is called vaktapasya, the spiritual silence. Then whatever you speak becomes priya, because it motivates people, inspires people to find silence in them, atmadnana in them. It is said that Sri Krishna is Parabrahma, Paramatma. He is a Mahayogi, Mahajnani. throughout his life, he is entirely engaged in activity for the loka kalyana or benefit of the world. Even when he speaks, there is silence in him. That is real silence. Even when you act, there is inactivity in you. That is real non-doership. So we have to find that self or atma in us, which is of the nature of silence. The real silence. Everything else is a activity. We have to be silent in all our activities. We have to be silent when you have to recognize I am silent even when I am speaking. That is the vak tapasya or spiritual silence. When the instruction is given, be silent. In reality, find the spirit, atma, which is silent. So then when you speak also, you are silent. It's like a wheel. A wheel can rotate, but the axle doesn't rotate. The axle is still. The entire rotation of the wheel is because of the axle. Similarly, entire operation of our body and mind is because of the atma, the self, which is not moving. Among all intense activities, the self is non-moving. So we have to recognize we are the self amidst all the activities, amidst all the speak, amidst all the talk. And that self is stillness and silence. You are that self, you are that atma. And the atma is Brahman, the supreme reality. Recognizing this is called silence of speech, tattvamasi. If you don't understand the spiritual teaching properly, the life can be messed up. We do the wrong way we understand, and we start living a life. Let us say I tell you, be silent. Then you don't speak, but mind will be noisy. In your noise, the relationships, the family, the work gets disturbed. That's suppression. Being silent is not suppression. Being silent is not stopping your expression. Being silent is your being is silent. Being means atma. You are a human being. The being is atma. Have you recognized your being? Being silent or silence is being. Recognize that. Recognize the atma. Then your words will be moderate, your speech will be moderate, your actions will be moderate, and that brings beauty, harmony, love and joy to all. This is called vak tapasya. Follow the vak tapasya.